Lupin, Vinita has consistently registered high margins for the past few quarters. Do you expect to maintain these going forward?
So if you look at our EBITDA margin for the last two quarters, so Q1 and Q2, they've been at this 28% level. And prior to that, in the last year, it went from the beginning of the year from 23% to 26%. So we've had a consistent improvement on our EBITDA and believe that we should be able to sustain the 28% level over the next couple of quarters. In terms of our outlook, based on the trend that we are seeing in most of our businesses in this quarter, for the last couple of months, we hope to end up at 18% or thereabouts in top line growth.
Right. Vinita, so my final question, twofold. What specific challenges do you foresee in the next quarter, and also your word on some of the ongoing issues with trade associations that pharma companies are facing?
So I think the question is really related. The ongoing challenge, I would say, this quarter is, or the next two quarters, is still to see how the trade momentum picks up over the next couple of months. We've seen a nice revival of our India business in the last couple of months and have an interim arrangement with the trade that we have struck over the last few weeks, but still have to come up with a long-term solution that we have yet to see. So that continues to be a challenge. We have been able to work through the challenge and grow our business. So believe that we should be able to grow our business despite this challenge. In terms of other challenges, we continue to wait for approvals on our products in the U.S. We had planned to launch 15 to 20 products this year in the U.S. market, and so far have launched 9, and I'm hoping to get additional approvals in the balance of the fiscal year.